Whether you're installing a towel rack, putting up a shelf, or mounting a TV, we've all been there, asking ourselves, am I using the right screws? Is this strong enough to hold up my TV? How much weight can it hold? What's a stud and why do I need to find one? All this can be terrifying, but trust me, it's not as terrifying as it seems. And if you do mess up, don't worry, it's not the end of the world. Patching it up is pretty easy too. In this video, I'm going to show you the basics of how to drive almost anything on your wall, and when you're done, how to patch it up to make it seem like you weren't even there. We're going to cover how to find the right place to drill into your wall, how to choose the right anchor to support your screw, what are the basics when mounting a heavy item, how to remove an anchor, and how to patch up a hole. Check out the time codes in the description below to skip around to the different parts of the video. The first step in hanging anything is knowing where to start drilling. Technically, you could drive a screw anywhere on your wall, but if you want the screw to hold up, you want to drill into the studs of the wall. Studs are the supports hidden behind the drywall. They are the vertical system of supports that run from the ceiling to the floor and are part of the overall frame of the building. Most studs are 16 to 24 inches apart. The easiest way to find a stud is by using a stud finder. Commonly, there are two types of stud finders: electric and magnetic. Magnetic stud finders will locate the nails in the studs and will latch on when it's over the nail. This will give you a rough idea where the stud is located. Once you find the nail on the stud, it helps to knock on the wall to find where the stud is. Areas without a stud will sound hollow. Areas with a stud will give a deeper thump sound. Electronic stud finders are a little trickier. Whenever you're using an electronic stud finder, make sure you read the instructions and you run the stud finder a few times before drilling into the wall. Some stud finders are a little more advanced and will indicate where the center of the stud is on the wall. Even with these tools, there's always a chance that you can get a false positive when finding your stud. The best way to avoid this is to make sure that you run your stud finder multiple times so that you have an accurate reading. Drilling into the stud of the wall is always the best option, especially when you're hanging something heavy. But you don't always have that luxury. Drywall anchors come in a variety of different options and weight capacities. Depending on what you need, some anchors make more sense. When choosing an anchor, always check the packaging for its weight capacity. Some anchors carry more or less weight depending on its size and depending on what it's drilling into. For the purpose of this video, we're going to cover anchors going into drywalls. There are a lot of different anchors, but here are five common anchors that cover light, medium, and heavy weights. Plastic expansion anchors are probably what comes into mind when you think of a drywall anchor. These guys are pretty common and are usually provided when you buy a picture frame or any kind of kit that requires you to hang anything. Sometimes when you buy this in bulk, the manufacturer will even provide the pre-drilled bit inside the kit. To install the expansion anchors into the wall, you just have to pre-drill into the wall, lightly hammer the anchor into the wall, and then drive the provided screw right into the anchor. The anchor will expand as the screw is driven in. Like I said before, always check the packaging for the weight capacity of any anchor. These are great for light, small weight items. If you don't have the drill bits to pre-drill in your anchors, threaded or self-drilling anchors are a great alternative and they can carry a little bit more weight depending on its size. Unlike plastic expansion anchors, self-drilling anchors don't require drill bits or a hammer to install. They are a little pricier and they do make a slightly bigger hole in the wall, but they are way more convenient to use. To install the anchor, simply push the tip of the anchor into the drywall and then carefully drive it in. Drive the provided screw into the anchor, and just like the plastic expansion anchors, the anchor will expand on the other side of the drywall. If you're planning on hanging something a little heavier, hollow wall anchors, also known as molly bolts, are a great option. Historically, these weren't a really great option because you had to buy a special tool to hammer them into the wall, but modern molly bolts don't really need that tool anymore. These anchors don't need to be pre-drilled into the wall, but they do need to be hammered in lightly. To expand your anchor, you have to remove the screw inside the barrel for the barrel to expand and the anchor to latch onto the wall. These guys are great for slightly heavier things, but like I said, you always want to check the weight capacity before using any kind of anchor. If you're planning on hanging something a little heavier, toggle bolts and snap toggle bolts are a great option, and they each come with their own set of pros and cons. Toggle bolts can carry a lot of weight and they're relatively easy to install, but there's little room for error when you're installing them. Compared to the other anchors, toggle bolts require a large pre-drill hole. To install a toggle bolt, flatten the anchor and then slip it into the pre-drill hole of the wall. The anchor will open up, and all you have to do is drive the screw into the wall to tighten the anchor. Toggle bolts can carry a lot of weight, but they can easily fall behind the wall when unscrewed. For the most part, they are a one-time use item, but out of all the anchors, they're the easiest to remove. Snap toggle bolts are a great alternative, but they do carry slightly less weight compared to regular toggle bolts. Even though you have to pre-drill into the wall, the great thing about snap toggle bolts, the tip of the anchor can be used to pre-drill into the wall. Simply rotate the head of the anchor, then use the anchor tip to pre-drill into the wall. Insert the anchor tip into the wall and then carefully pull the cap toward the wall to lock the anchor in place. Once the anchor has been tightened, snap the extra plastic off of the anchor. Compared to regular toggle bolts, the bolt will stay in place when the screw is removed. There are a bunch of specialized anchors, but for the most part, these are probably the ones that you'll need to use in your household. When you're mounting something heavy, mounting it onto the stud is always the best option. A trick that I like to use when finding the stud is marking each stud I find with a piece of painter's tape. Once you find the studs, use a measuring tape to measure out the 16 or 24 inch space between the two studs. The first thing that comes to mind when mounting something heavy is a TV. These four little markers indicate the corners of the TV. To start off, I measured out a horizontal line and used a level to ensure that it's straight. You're going to be using a level at almost every step of this process, but trust me, it's just going to make it easier in the end. Find the center of your line and make a mark. Depending on the type of mount that you're using, it may or may not be installed in the direct center of your wall. This TV mount is a little off-center since it swivels out. Place your level on the longer end of your TV mount to ensure that it's straight and then mark the points where you're going to drill into the wall. When I'm mounting something heavy, I like to use this trick to get a better idea of what's on the other side of the wall. Take your tiniest drill bit and drill into the center of your marks. If it goes straight through, then it's drywall. If you feel a little resistance when you're drilling past the drywall, chances are you're drilling into the stud. In this case, we're drilling through a stud. Occasionally, cable boxes and power outlets are located right next to a stud, but you still want to use a stud finder to make sure. If you can't drill into a stud, make sure you use the appropriate wall anchor to mount your TV. I like to use toggle bolts because they can carry a large weight load. When you're using toggle bolts, you have to thread the screw through the mount before they're installed into the wall. Whether you're drilling straight into the drywall or you're drilling into the stud, make sure you're using the right size drill bit to pre-drill into your wall. The packaging will indicate which drill bit to use. Place your mount over the pre-drilled holes, and again, use a level to ensure that it's straight. Loosely drive in the middle screw of your mount. At this point, you don't want to tighten it yet, just because you want it to be loose enough to make adjustments. The holes on your mount are oval so that you can make minor adjustments when you're installing your mount. Once your mount is leveled, tighten the middle screws and then drive and tighten the remaining screws. You can use this technique when you're installing other TV mounts, heavy shelving, or anything that needs to be installed into a stud. Place your TV on your wall mount. Before locking it in place, use a level one last time to make sure that it's straight, because the last thing that you need is a crooked TV after doing this much work. As easy as it is to install an anchor, it's surprisingly easy to remove one. First, remove the screw from the anchor. Self-drilling screws are probably the easiest one to remove. All you have to do is unscrew it. Plastic expansion anchors are a little trickier to remove. Carefully use a box cutter blade to cut the lip of the anchor off, and then take a screwdriver and just pop it into the other side of the wall. Molly bolts are a little trickier because they're metal and they've expanded three ways into your wall. Carefully drive the screw about halfway out of the wall. Lightly hammer the screw into the anchor. This will undo the anchor and will retract the metal barrel. This will loosen the molly bolt and you'll be able to pull it right out. Toggle bolts are the easiest to remove since you literally just have to remove the screw and the toggle bolt will fall right off. Snap toggle bolts are a little trickier. First, remove the screw from the anchor, and then, using a screwdriver, hammer the rest of the toggle bolt into the wall. Once everything has been removed from your wall, it's time to patch things up. For small holes, you're really only going to need three things: spackle, a putty knife, and some sandpaper. Patching up small holes is literally as easy as applying spackle onto the hole with a putty knife, and then running the putty knife multiple directions to remove any extra spackle. It's literally that easy. For larger holes, apply the first layer of spackle and let it completely dry. You'll notice for larger holes, the spackle will slightly sink in as it dries. You'll need to apply another light layer of spackle to bring it to level to the rest of your wall. Once the spackle is dry, sand it down with some sandpaper, and apply a new layer of paint, and you're all set.
Hopefully these tips gave you the boost of confidence that you need to hang that picture frame or coat hook onto the wall, and to patch it all up when you're done.